Praise be to Jesus. Good morning, friends. Today, the second Sunday of Kaitha, period of the fruits. Readings are Deuteronomy chapter 4, verses 32 to 40, Isaiah chapter 4, verses 2 to 6, 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 4 to 12, and the Gospel of St. Luke chapter 15, verses 11 to 32. Moses asked the people to acknowledge the love of God, who chose them as his people and delivered them from slavery. Keep his statutes and his commandments. These are the fruits expected of them. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verses 32 to 40. Isaiah chapter 4, verses 2 to 6 foretells the future glory of Jerusalem. Those who are left in Jerusalem and the survivors of Zion will see this glory, the glorious fruits of Jerusalem. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 4 to 12 is the third reading. The minister of the new covenant have confidence and competence, which is obtained from Christ Jesus. They produce fruits of evangelization. In the Gospel reading, Luke chapter 15, verses 11 to 32, we have the parable of the lost son, the loving, compassionate, and forgiving father, and the unforgiving, judging, self-centered brother, and the lost son. The loving, compassionate father who was ready to forgive the younger son, who took away with him all his share and squandered it. And then when he was bankrupt, he came back to the father. But the father was waiting for him, looking for him. And the moment he saw him coming from afar, he ran out of the house and came to him, embraced him, welcomed him, and ordered a dinner for him, and immediately got his dress changed and his sandals changed and made a big feast because he got his lost son. He was very happy. He was the embodiment of compassion, kindness, love, and paternal care for the son. The second character is the son himself, the youngest son, who left the father. And without any care for his father, he went away and wasted all his money and then came back. When it came to his mind that at his father's home, the people are living comfortably and he is starving in the distant place in the foreign country, he came back. He repented and asked pardon from father, and he promised that he would lead a new life. And the third character is the elder brother. He is of a strange character. He pretended to be an obedient son, but in the heart of heart, he was not even a servant, less than a servant. He had a slavish mentality, and he did not love his brother. When his brother returned, he did not enjoy it. When he heard the news that his brother had returned, and his father was giving a dinner for everybody, he did not even enter the home, refused to come inside. So the loving father came to him and said and pleaded with him that it was just and fitting that we celebrate when the younger son has returned. He even accused his brother of wasting the money with prostitutes, of which he did not have any proof at all. He simply accused him. Of course, he might have wasted the money that he had. So the elder brother, another character of the whole story. Victor Hugo, the famous 19th century French novelist, in his book Les Miserables, The Poor, brings in a character, Shang Wang Shan. He was convicted and imprisoned for 19 years. and his cry was, he stole a packet of bread. Later he tried to escape from the prison. And when the convict was released from the prison, the ex-convict wanted to lead a new life, but nobody was ready to accept him or even talk to him. At last he knocked at the door of the bishop of the city, and the bishop welcomed him. He was a very kind man, and he took care of him as a member of his family, and Shang Wang Chan lived in the bishop's residence. After some time, he stole the silverware, costly silverware, from the bishop's residence and escaped. He was caught by the police, and then he was brought back to the bishop's house. Then bishop said, this is a gift that I have given to him. So the police could not arrest him. Then the bishop made him promise that he would lead a decent life, a just life. And Shang Wang Chan promised that he would lead a new life. And he left the place, went to the nearby city, where he developed a new technology for producing, for manufacturing certain things. And the people of the city also picked up the new technology. And the city became very famous and rich. And Shang Wang Chan was made the mayor of the city. So the story goes on like that. Here we see the story of a convict, an ex-convict, who wanted to mend his life and start a new life, but the people were not ready to accept it. And he was helped only by the bishop, who was a very kind and compassionate person. The younger son in the story told by Jesus in the parable comes back home. His brother had the attitude of not allowing him, not accepting him. He was not ready to give him another chance to lead a new life. But the father was so kind and considerate, compassionate, accepted him with love and considered him as own son. Lord Jesus, we thank you for telling us the beautiful story. We thank you for giving us a glimpse of the love and compassion and kindness of the Father in heaven. Give us the grace that we may return to him whenever we are away from him. Give us the grace that we may, like the Father in heaven, welcome those who are gone away from you, and also give them a chance to build up their life in a new way. Lord, give us the grace to be compassionate and kind and produce the fruits of evangelization, the fruits of the gospel in our lives. Amen.